Welcome back to episode 5 of our Manchester City FM16 Let's Play. Jen Caldo here, and we are starting off today with our fourth Champions League game. This one against Steaua Bucharest away from home. If we win this, we'll move on to 12 points and be assured of our place in the next round. Not that I don't think we'd qualify from this point. So I'm resting a few players today. We have got a big game against Spurs in the league next, who are 1 point ahead of us in the title race. I think that's away from home possibly as well, so we really need a good performance there. So it's finding the right mix of getting the win today to keep the morale up, but not risking any of our key players getting injured. I've got a few youngsters on the bench that we can bring in. David Silva will be one of the first to come off, I think, and Florenzi too. The defence is still quite strong. Company sitting this one out. But I'm hoping we'll get a good win and keep a clean sheet too. This is actually the first highlight of the game here on almost the hour mark, and it's Steaua who've got it. Pintilli bringing it forward. We've dominated the game, but not been able to turn that into a real chance yet. David Silva, though, with an opportunity here, finds Fernando. Can we get that goal? I think one goal would probably be enough today, but I also think that the floodgates will probably open if we can get it. Sabletta's found Barker, and Barker's scored from such a tight angle. What a young player he's turning out to be. Brilliant at filling in, especially with the injury to Raheem Sterling at the moment. And we've got the lead away from home against Steaua Bucharest. Steaua with the opportunity to draw a leveller here. Can they get the cross in? It's Chipchu. Kaja. Pinilli finds Chipchu, and they have equalised. I made a raft of substitutions, brought on the young players, and we've given away the lead there. Steaua have definitely come into the game more since we scored. Could this be the last chance of the match? Barker bringing it forward. I really don't want to be dropping points here. Stones puts it into Barker, and he scored, and I think he's onside too. He is. It's 2-1. Brandon Barker, this is his night. Two goals. He's snatched the win here in the 89th minute for us. This kick will end the match. There it is. Brandon Barker winning it for us right at the death. That should put us through in the Champions League. But an excellent performance from him. So this is it. This is a big one. First versus second in the league. Just 1 point separating us. We are away from home against the league leaders. I've got my full strength squad out there. I think we've got a chance of winning this. I'd be happy with a point. Staying within touching distance is the main thing. I don't think it'd be the end of the world if we did lose. We haven't lost. Well, I think we've only lost once this season so far. Only failed to win two games in total. We're in November now, so we're playing very good football. I'm very certain that Tottenham will falter as they get in towards the latter part of the season. Most of the leaders tend to in this game. So I'm hoping if we do win this match, we can start to open up a points gap going into the winter period. But losing shouldn't be the end of the world. So let's jump into it and see how we do. Tottenham have the first highlight, but De Bruyne has stolen the ball there. Oh, just wide of the post. Tottenham just started to take control of this match a bit. It was very close on shots in the first half, but they've pulled away in the second. We have got the ball though. Very even on possession. That ball over the top looking for Aguero's cutout. Nasri now has released Gabriel Barbosa and he has scored. Tottenham have the lead and we've got 30 minutes now to try and get something out of this game. Lamela now looking to come forward. Tottenham can kill this game off with another goal, I think. We've not really been at the races today. But Fabian Delph has won that ball and immediately given it to Ryan Mason. We can work it out from the back again though. Company now. Played forward. Walker's got there. You can see that they're just a step ahead of us in almost every department. Much slicker passing. Here's Walker. Puts it across. Just about cleared out. This has all been quite comfortable for Spurs so far. Hugo Lloris with the ball. Out to Otamendi. Do we have one more chance? Here's David Silva. Finds Aguero. Silva! And it's there. We've got the equaliser in the 90th minute. Just not deserved at all. But David Silva was there with a rebound for one all. And we are back in this match. This is the last throw of the dice for Tottenham. Samir Nasri. Back to Barbosa. Company clears it out. Can we get that point? Given how much Tottenham have been dominating us today. I will be happy with a point. And we have got it. Keeps us within 1 point of Spurs at the top of the table. I think that makes us the favourites for the title on that basis. Not happy with the team for failing to get the win, but just 1 point behind Spurs, 3 points clear of Arsenal. The rest of the team sort of falling behind us, but I think it is us and Spurs for the title this season. We have the goal difference, but we need to get the win. They're still unbeaten. They are playing very well, but I think we have the stronger squad. Well, guys, we've had another international break and yet another injury nightmare. This time, Sergio Aguero has been injured on international duty with Argentina. He is going to be out for a month, another 3 weeks. It happened in the first match of the international break, so he has had a week to recover already. It does mean that he is likely to miss a few games, but I don't think too many of them are that important. He should be back in time for the Chelsea away match, which I think is the only real match of importance in there. We should be fine in the Capital One Cup quarterfinal, and if we drop points in the other matches, I don't think it's the end of the world. Wilfred Bonny should be able to do a job. He hasn't been too bad in the games where he's had to fill in, and Kelechi Iheanacho has certainly got a few goals, so I think we are covered. Just not ideal. He is a goal machine, Sergio Aguero. I think he's got something like 10 goals already this season. 10 in 14, which shows how important he is to us. But I think Bonny can do a job. He's been on form, up with the rest of the team in terms of ratings. Yaya Toure's fit to start a match again. Sterling's coming back. So I think we should be okay. And I think we should beat Everton today as well. First chance for us. Here's Fernando to Zabaleta. Puts into De Bruyne. Fernando with it on the edge of the area. He's found Florenzi in space. And Bezic has given away the penalty. We've got a chance here. Yet another penalty for us. It looks like Yaya Toure is going to step up and take it again. I think he's scored every penalty he's taken so far this season. So hopefully he can do the same here. He does step up. And he scores it. I think the goalkeeper maybe got a touch on that, but it doesn't matter. He's got his seventh of the season, and we are in front here against Everton in a key match for us. Free kick here from De Bruyne. He was looking for company at the back post. Clichy's picked it up, though. He's got Silva there. Now Toure with a chance. Will he strike it? He does. Silva on the rebound. Oh, Howard with a double save. He's done very well there. De Bruyne now. Finds Florenzi. He's got Silva down the left. Silva can whip a ball in from deep. He does. There's De Bruyne. And there's 2-0. We've had six shots so far in this match, and all six have been on target, leading to two goals. Definitely finding our shooting boots, but Everton have got the chance here. Coleman tries to put it in. It is cut out. Silva now can break to Wilfred Bonny. Not seen much of him yet. Tackle comes in, though. He's giving the ball away. Everton looking to come back at us. Barkley now. Just putting them under pressure, but it is leaving gaps in behind. Now McCarthy. Kaku finds Morales, and he has scored. It's 2-1. A good Everton goal there. We put them under pressure, but they kept finding the space in behind. Here come Everton again with De La Feu looking to get the equaliser. Clichy's made a tackle there, but what was Joe Hart doing? Lukaku's missed an open goal, and that is a free life for us there. Joe Hart can clear this out. I really want a third goal. We've been living on the edge here. Otamendi now. Finds Clichy. Oh, it's a bit scrappy in midfield, but Kompany's got a chance here. The ball breaks. Now we're for Bonny. Zabaleta can put in a good ball. Finds Florenzi. It's 3-1. That is the cushion we needed. I think that will see us through. We've been playing with fire at the back, but that should give us the unassailable lead that we need. Another chance here. Can we make it 4-1? Toure puts a free kick out to Zabaleta. He's got options in the middle. He finds Toure. And there's De Bruyne. Offside flags up. I had a feeling he might have been off. And the linesman raised his flag. Remains 3-1, but a good sign from us. Barkley's found Lukaku over the top, nearly at the end of the match. But McCarthy, oh, inside of the post, so close to another nervy finish for us. Otamendi's picked up a knock here, but I think this will be full time. It's another good win for us. Not getting the clean sheets I'd like, but I think when you play the kind of attacking football that we are, With high pressing, you are likely to concede goals, but you will score quite a few too. And there it is, 3-1. Another good win for us. We're keeping up that excellent form. Everton are a bit of a bogey team sometimes, so I'm very happy to get out of that with 3 points. Between matches, I was offered a new contract by Manchester City, which I accepted. So that 12-month contract is extended, I think, to 4 years now. Tottenham also drew in their game. So if we have a look at the competitions, you can see we are 1 point clear of the top at the table now. Tottenham and Arsenal still unbeaten, though. Both put them in good efforts there. But 10 wins from 13 games, very happy with that. As you can see, if we win today, we will not only secure qualification, but we also secure top of the table, which will give us, hopefully, a good draw in the first knockout round. Resting a few players today. Company's gone out, given the youngster Adara Bioyo. I think is his name. Giving him a game anyway. John Stones in there. Fabian Delph coming in centre midfield. Sterling needs to get his match fitness up, so he'll start on the left. Otherwise, pretty strong team. I do want to get another win, keep up the good form, let those wins keep rolling into each other, and look ahead to our game at Stoke at the weekend. Leon looking to come forward here with Gazal. Connor Lons in midfield. Putting them under pressure, forced to go back to Umtiti. Sabaleta's won the ball back for us. Can we launch a break here? De Bruyne charging forward. He seems to be having an upturning form. He's found Sabaleta free on the right. Cuts inside, puts the ball in, and Bonny is there. 1-0. An excellent, excellent move there. Putting pressure, getting the ball back, counter-attacking quickly, and whipping the ball in for Wilfred Bonny to give us a lead. Oh, Leon have given the ball away there. And Titi just about recovers. Lacazette now looks down the line. I think we should get there first. John Stones does. And we play it out from the back here. Instead, Joe Hart's put it forward. Sissoko picks up the second ball. De Bruyne cutting inside. Chips over to Wilfred Bonny. Ah, defender's just getting the way there to block it. But it's gone immediately into another highlight here. Leon maybe looking to get the equaliser. Finds Fekir out on the right. We've done very well with our tackling today. But Fekir's broken away from the defender there. And found Valbuena. And it's 1-1. Matthew Valbuena coming out from midfield there to give Leon the equaliser. Here we've got the free kick. Sterling to Fernando. Can he find Sterling? He does. Slips it inside. There's Sissoko. And Sissoko scores. 2-1 back in front. Deservedly so. We've been much a better team. We just need to hold on to this. Make sure we get the 3 points. Free kick for Leon. Put into Lacazette. What happened there? Joe Hart in no man's land. Lacazette just with an open goal behind him. And it's 2-2. Zabaleta's corner. Finds Barker. Looking for Stones at the far corner. It's dropped to Iheanacho. We've got the lead back. We won 4-3 away from home. It's 3-2 at home. What a high scoring couple of games this has been against Leon. Leon coming forward again. Can they get another equaliser? Equaliser for the third time in this match, I think. Chalet now finds Valbuena. Lacazette, the danger man. There he is again. Finds Valbuena, who's just put that wide. I really thought they were going to equalise again there. Just 5 minutes left. Oh, Sissoko gave that ball away and Chalet nearly scored, but Hart was there. Dangerous football in defence. Ball cleared out here. Raphael puts it across. That should be the full-time whistle. It is another win, 5 from 5 in the Champions League so far. Hard fought, but well deserved. Today it's top versus bottom. We are visiting Stoke, who've already sacked manager Mark Hughes. So they're sitting bottom of the league. We're going to play them again in 3 days in the Capital One Cup quarterfinal. So we don't need to worry about resting too many players. We are going to be in the same situation as Stoke, although I don't think they had a midweek game before this match like we did. But the team's still relatively fresh. I don't know if we've got somebody who can come in for Zabaleta, who is better. Maybe if we put Florenzi in there and somebody else down the right wing. Probably Raheem Sterling, given the game time. Otherwise, quite a strong squad out there, not taking any chances. I want to get the win. It is the end of November, so it really is a cold, wet night in Stoke. But hopefully we can get the 3 points and keep up our position at the top of the league. Stoke with a nice crisscross pattern on their pitch have managed to pick out Diouf with a diagonal ball. He's put that wide. Here's our first chance of the match. Wilfried Bony on the ball, finds Fabian Delph. Sterling's at the far corner, he has picked up the ball to Florenzi. Sterling again here, finds Silva, and there is the lead away at Stoke, an important lead against the bottom club. Sometimes you can slip up in these easy matches, but it looks like we're going to win today. Get 3 points on the board. Florenzi's corner, finds Silva. That is cleared out. Mame Biram Diouf can bring this away. Much preferred to El Hadj Diouf, who, if anybody remembers, was a total wanker. But Diouf taken out there. Touré finds Delph, who can slip through Bonny. Can Bonny make it two? Just wide. Stoke playing it short at the back here. It can be dangerous with our high-pressing tactic. They managed to clear it, though. Now Ibrahim Afellay can bring it forward. Looks for Diouf, who's been all over the place today. Adam finds Afellay. Whelan's got Muneja out in oceans of space. He finds Afellay. We've just about cleared that. Sterling now can counter-attack. Wilfried Bonny's got David Silva on the left if he can pick him out. Johnson gets there, but Silva's picked it up and scores. 2-0. Excellent work from David Silva to recover that ball and give us the advantage. Another highlight before half-time here. Stoke looking to get something back from this game. Delph with the foul. I think that's the second yellow. He's off. We've picked up a lot of yellows today, been very aggressive, and it's certainly cost us there. Fernando's going to have to move up into the centre of the pitch. Not going to change too much otherwise. We are playing well. We are 2-0 up, and I think we'll be fine. Free kick from Sterling. Puts in looking for Silva, and even with 10 men, we extend the lead to 3-0. That should make the second half very comfortable, and we can maybe rotate the players as fatigue sets in. Walshy clears it to Afellay. Mame Biram Diouf on the ball. Can he find a cross? He puts it in. Shaqiri's at the back post, and Stoke have got a goal back straight away in the second half. We need to make sure we don't concede another too early here. Otherwise, we could be in for trouble. Silva with a free kick in towards Iheanacho. Cleared out. Oh, and they've got a man free down the left here. Is Ibrahim Afellay, who immediately puts it to the right wing. Shaqiri looking for Afellay again, and that would have been a great counter-attacking goal, but it's gone wide. And it looks like our 10 men have won the match 3-1. An excellent performance from hat-trick hero David Silva today, picking up a 9.5 rating. He's been brilliant. Sterling was brilliant too. I have to issue a warning to Fabian Delph for giving away the red card there, but overall, very happy with that. A good end to the episode. We'll just have a look at where we are in the league. 4 points clear, but Tottenham do have a game in hand. I'm not sure who they're going to be playing. Issue that warning to Fabian Delph for two yellows. My normal policy is a warning for two yellows and red, and 2 weeks' wages if you get a straight red card, and it tends to keep the discipline in shape. I don't pick up many red cards when I take that approach. If we just have a look at the competitions at the end of this episode, top of the league, 4 points clear, comfortably through in the Champions League, already won the group, and their next match is against Stoke again in a few days' time in the Capital One Cup quarterfinal. We should get a win there, which will allow us to focus on our Premier League games. Next episode, we've got a big game away from home against Chelsea. I might risk losing the Zenit match. I don't want to damage morale, but a draw would be fine. It is away from home. At Chelsea, and I do want to get the win there. Chelsea, currently fifth in the league, so they're not having the best season. But after Chelsea, we've got another very comfortable run in the league, although the FA Cup will kick off around this time, just afterwards. So we should be able to hopefully stretch our legs at the top of the table, get a few points on the board, especially if we beat Chelsea. But tune in next time to see how we get on. See if we can carry on our position at the top of the league and go for that quadruple. Thanks very much for watching the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you've enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.